Hey everyone, my name is Ahmed and I'm going to present our paper Stable Policy Optimization via of Policy Divergence Regularization. This is a joint work with Amy Zong, Joël Pinault and Pascal Vincent. In this work, we are interested in designing conservative updates to ensure stable policy learning. So first, we propose to stabilize policy improvement by constraining the discounted state action visitation induced by consecutive policy to be close to each other. Secondly, we show how this constraint can be learned in adversarial and off-policy manner. And finally, we demonstrate the benefits of our approach through an empirical investigation. So our setting is the classical reinforcement learning paradigm, where the agent interacts repeatedly with the environment. The environment is formalized by Markov decision process, and the ultimate goal of the agent is to learn a policy in order to maximize the long-term numerical signal. The most widely used method for policy optimization could be categorized into families. So the first one is policy gradient method, which optimizes directly the cumulative rewards. And it's known that this method could suffer from large variance issue. And the second family is conservative approaches that optimize surrogate objectives that can provide local improvement. And in this family, we can find CPI, TRPU, PPU algorithms. And the main ingredient of these approaches is how to ensure that the new policy stays in the vicinity of the current policy. Conservative approaches are motivated by the following performance difference lemma. That states that the difference between the performance of policy pi prime and the policy pi can be written in terms of the advantage function of the policy pi, where the states are distributed according to this state visitation distribution induced by the policy pi prime. So we can derive from here a surrogate objective by replacing d pi prime by d pi I, where pi I is the current policy at iteration I. But this surrogate objective is only valid if we stay in the neighborhood of the policy pi I. And this requirement is implemented different ways. For example, CPI returns a stochastic mixture between the greedy policy and the current policy. TRPU solves the KL divergence constraint problem. And finally, PPU optimizes clipped objective. But you can see that all this method defines the closeness between policy only in terms of the immediate action probabilities. And this work, we argue that this could be suboptimal approximation, and we should rather reason about the long-term effect of policies on distribution of future states. And this intuition actually could be formalized clearly. From the performance lemma, we can provide two lower bounds on the policy performance. The first one involves a total variation between d pi prime and d pi, but this lower bound is not tractable because it requires access to d pi prime. And the second one, involves the total variation distance between the two policies, pi prime and pi, and this lower bound is tractable, but we pay an extra term of the planning horizon, which leads to a looser lower bound. So actually, ultimately, we are interested to optimize the tighter lower bound, which is the first one. And actually, we will show in this paper how to do this in tractable way. So first of all, it's more convenient to work with state action visitation distribution denote by mu pi instead of d pi. And our goal is to estimate the divergence between mu pi prime and the mu pi without access to the mu pi prime. So we know that the total variation distance belongs to class of phi divergences that we can find the expression here, where phi is convex function. But this expression is not practical because we need the analytic expression of p of mu pi prime. And that's why actually we use a variational representation that casts the measuring of the divergence into optimization problem over the function class f. But here the first term, which is an expectation over mu PyPrime. So we need to have access to sample from a new PyPrime. So to bypass this difficulty, we use a clever change of variable trick that was introduced in the paper Dual Dice for off policy evaluation. And the trick is to define a new variable g, which is a function that satisfies a Bellman equation with a reward replaced by the function f. And with some algebraic manipulation, we can express the divergence as a maximization problem over the new variable g, where the first expression is only over the initial distribution and not anymore over the distribution mu pi prime. So now actually we can optimize this distribution in off-policy manner. So our practical algorithm that we call PPU DICE will optimize the following min-max objective, where g here plays the role of the discriminator as in GAN, and pi prime plays the role of the generator. And to backpropagate gradient of the regularization term with respect to the policy, we can use score function estimator for discrete policies or representation trick for Gaussian policies. So first of all, we conducted some a set of initial experiments with different choices of divergence. And actually, we found out that the KL divergence performed consistently well across many environments. So in our subsequent experiments, we will use this KL divergence. Next, we wanted to test the sensitivity of our method with respect to the parameter lambda, and actually we came up with adapted version of lambda that is motivated by theoretical lower bound, and we found out that the adaptive version performed consistently better than any fixed value of lambda across many environments. And finally, we compare our method PPU DICE to PPU and TRPU in the many games in Atari benchmark as well as in Mojoco benchmark. And we can see here that our method PPU DICE provides a significant boost of performance. So as conclusion, in this work, we have argued that using the action probability to constrain the policy update is a suboptimal approximation to control the state visitation shift. We demonstrate how we can leverage DICE idea to compute the divergence between state action visitation distribution and use that to regularize the policy learning. And also we show empirically that our method beats PPU and TRPU in most environments in Atari and Mojoco benchmarks. And finally, we provide an open source implementation of our method. So finally, thank you for listening. And if you are interested in more details, please check the paper.